Today we will talk about internal forces in inclined beams. We will show how to draw the bending, shear, and normal diagrams for the shown inclined beam. But before we do that, we need to show why the inclined beam is different from the horizontal beam, and what are the challenges that we face when we analyze an inclined beam, and how we can overcome these challenges. There are mainly two issues that we need to discuss. Number one, most of the forces are in the X and Y directions, but the beam is inclined. Number two, how do we handle the uniform load on an inclined beam? Let us start by the first issue. In an inclined beam, the normal and shear forces will also be inclined. Therefore, we need to resolve the forces that are in the X and Y directions into their components in the normal N and shear Q directions. If the angle between the beam and the X direction is theta, then the angle between the N direction and X will also be theta, and the angle between the Q direction and Y will be theta as well. By resolving the X and Y forces into their components in the N and Q directions, we will find that the normal force N will be the sum of two components, X cosine theta and Y sine theta. And the shear force, Q, will be the sum of two components, X sine theta and Y cosine theta. The sine of these components will depend on the direction of the X and Y forces and the sine convention used for evaluating N and Q. For the shown sketch, the signs will be as shown. The second issue is related to the distributed load on the inclined beam. To illustrate our idea, let us consider a part of an inclined beam, part AB. The length of this inclined part is L. The horizontal projection of the length is LH, and the vertical projection is LV. The shown uniform load is distributed on the inclined length of the beam and has a vertical direction because the hatching is vertical. If the moments at points A and B are known, and we want to draw the moment diagram between A and B, then we must connect MA and MB using the parabola. If the beam is horizontal, the deflection of this parabola from the connecting line will be equal to the value of the load multiplied by the square of L divided by 8, where L is the length of AB. In the case of the inclined beam, the deflection of the parabola will be slightly different. It will be equal to the value of the load multiplied by L1 and L2 divided by 8. But what is L1 and L2? L1 is the length on which the load is distributed. And L2 is the length perpendicular to the direction of the load. The equivalent point load of this uniform load will be equal to W multiplied by L1. For the shown load, L1 will be equal to L, and L2 will be equal to LH, and the equivalent load will be equal to W multiplied by L. If the direction of the load is changed to be perpendicular to the beam, the load is still distributed on the inclined beam, so L1 will be equal to L, and the direction of the load will be perpendicular to the inclined length. So L2 will also be equal to L. The equivalent point load will be equal to W multiplied by L, and its direction will be perpendicular to the beam. If the direction of the load is changed to be horizontal, L1 will still be equal to L, but the direction of the load will be perpendicular to the vertical length. So L2 will be equal to LV. The equivalent point load will be horizontal, and will be equal to W multiplied by L. If the load is changed so it is vertical and distributed on the horizontal length, L1 will be equal to LH, and L2 will also be equal to LH. The equivalent point load will be vertical and will be equal to W multiplied by LH. If the load is changed so it is horizontal and distributed on the vertical length, L1 will be equal to LV, and L2 will also be equal to LV. equivalent point load will be horizontal and will be equal to W multiplied by LV. Now let us return to our example. First, we will evaluate the reactions, then we will calculate the cosine and sine of the angle theta. Then we will proceed to construct the internal force diagrams. As detailed in a previous lecture, this is done by evaluating the internal forces at key critical points. Then we connect between the points to finalize the diagrams. We start from the left by working on the point just to the right of point A. We will divide the beam into two parts at that point, and we will use one of the parts to calculate the internal forces. We are free to use the left or the right part, but take care that the sign convention for the left part is opposite to that of the right part. For the current point, we will work on the left part, so we will display the sign convention of the left part for reference. To calculate the normal and shear values at the considered point, we first have to calculate the sum of all the forces in the left part. We will call the sum of all the horizontal forces, x, and the sum of all the vertical forces, y. X will be 9 kN pointing right, and y will be 16.5 kN pointing up. We then resolve these forces into their components in the N and Q directions, as shown in the sketch. By summing all the components in the N direction using the reference sign convention, the normal force is found to be negative 14.65 kN. Similarly, by summing the components in the Q direction, the shear force is found to be positive 11.77 kN. Because all the forces in the left part pass through point A, the moment about A will be zero. Next, we evaluate the internal forces at the next critical point, which will be just to the left of point C. We will divide the beam into two parts at that point, and we will use the left part. We will convert the distributed load in the left part to an equivalent concentrated force, which will be equal to 3 kN per meter multiplied by the inclined length, which is 6.5 meters, giving an equivalent force of 19.5 kN located 3 meters from point C. Because at the left of point C, the beam is inclined, we will calculate the normal and shear forces in the same way used in the previous step. We will calculate the sum of all the horizontal and vertical forces in the left part. X will be 9 kN pointing right, as before, and Y will be the sum of 16.5 kN pointing up and 19.5 kN pointing down. The result will be 3 kN pointing down. We then resolve these forces into their components in the N and Q directions and sum the components in both directions using the reference sign convention. The normal force is found to be negative 7.15 kN. This value is drawn on the diagram and connected to the value calculated in the previous step using a straight line. The shear force is found to be negative 6.23 kN and is drawn on the diagram similar to the normal force. The value of the moment will be calculated by taking the moment of all the forces in the left part about point C. The left part contains three forces, YA, which will be multiplied by an arm of 6 meters, rotating in the positive direction, XA, which is multiplied by an arm of 2.5 meters, rotating in the negative direction, and the 19.5 kN equivalent force, which is multiplied by an arm of 3 meters, rotating in the negative direction. By summing all the terms, the moment is found to be positive 18 kN meter. The evaluated value is drawn on the diagram at point C and connected to the value at point A using a parabola as shown. The deflection of the parabola from the straight line connecting the moment values is evaluated as W multiplied by L1 and L2 divided by 8. L1 be the inclined distance, which is 6.5 meters, because the load is distributed over the inclined distance, and L2 will be the horizontal distance, 6 meters, because it is perpendicular to the vertical direction of the load. Next, we evaluate the internal forces at the next critical point, which will be the point just to the right of point C. Because the considered point is at the right of point C, it will be located on the horizontal part of the beam, and therefore the normal force will be in the horizontal direction and the shear force will be in the vertical direction. We will use the right part and we will display the sign convention of the right part for our reference. We will convert the uniform load in the right part to an equivalent force, which will be equal to 2 kN per meter multiplied by the length of 3 meters, giving 6 kN. The normal force will be the sum of all the horizontal forces in the right part. The right part only contains one horizontal force of 9 kN, so the normal force will be negative 9 kN. The shear force will be the sum of two forces, negative YB and the positive 6 kN equivalent force, giving a shear value of negative 3 kN. The bending moment is calculated by taking the moment of all the forces in the right part about point C. The bending moment will be the sum of two terms, YB multiplied by 3 meters rotating in the positive direction, and the 6 kN equivalent force multiplied by 1.5 meter rotating in the negative direction. The moment value will be 18 kN meter. Finally, we evaluate the internal forces at the point just to the left of the support at B. We will work on the right part and we will display the sign convention for the right part for reference. The normal force will be negative 9 kN as before. The right part in this case only contains one vertical force, which is the reaction YB of 9 kN pointing upwards. So the shear force will be negative 9 kN. Because all the forces in the right part pass through point B, the moment about B will be zero. The moment value is connected to that calculated at the previous step using a parabola as shown. After connecting all the calculated values, the final diagrams are produced.